Although this example may appear to be abstract, it is actually quite realistic because it is similar to many real-world APT instances. In this example, the CEO gets an email with a PDF attachment showing pie charts of sales activities. When he opens the PDF document inside browser, for example, so that he can use the Acrobat Reader plugin to view the document, the crafted attack data embedded in the PDF document would cause a zero-day exploit that broke out the plugin sandbox in the browser and compromised the browser. And the detail of such attack can be, for example, a buffer overflow attack that lead to control flow hijacking and taking over the browser. Then the injected attack code would download a malicious browser extension. Recall that a malicious browser extension is a malware embedded within the browser. From this point on, each time the CEO sends an email to his employees with an attachment, for example, a PDF document, the malicious browser extension would infect the attachments. Eventually, the malware gets on the computer of a user who has admin privilege of the company's server, and therefore the malware can steal the credentials that will lead the malware into access to the company's servers. From this point on, the malware can then steal the most valuable data from the company. This example captures a number of key characteristics of APTs. First, the users, including the sysadmins, do not realize that their computers and network have been compromised. Second, the APT activities blend in with normal user activity. For example, the APT does not just send email by itself, it only modifies the emails sent by the CEO. Third, it takes its time in order to get to the key individual and steal his credentials.